Welcome back to the TI5 Chinese Qualifiers, sponsored by Very Long Post Game Discussions. And because of that,
why you gotta hate, dude?
We're going straight into Dota. Game 3. Draft is on the way. On its way.
Alright, whatever.
Let's go.
So, okay. I wanted to ask a question really quick, as we're gonna probably get the draft up in a second.
You can take your time.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I know I can take my time. Yeah. It's like, we got all the time in the world in the draft. It's fine. So, I'll give you some spoilers, JK. We'll see it on screen. Energy Pacemaker, first ban, the Batrider. I had a question is, do you think that Energy Pacemaker would feel comfortable enough doing the same thing twice against Wings?
No, that was a one time thing.
What they just did? That strat or the first game strat?
No, I mean like what they just did.
Okay, so no.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, they might feel comfortable, but it would be a big mistake, I think. Wings are not going to make the same mistake again.
They even ban the Undying. Okay. Yeah.
Well, it's interesting that EP have been Dire every game, but first pick is actually swapped. So it seems EP prefer Dire anyways. Well, which is unconventional. Like, most teams prefer Radiant these days.
Yeah, that's true as well. I just thought it was a bit odd that you would ban a hero like Batrider, even if you weren't planning on doing the same thing. Because I think Batrider is actually really good against Deathball in the sense that the high ground becomes significantly harder. And oh dear.
Oh, it's happening.
That's a draw wiper.
Can I change my prediction to EP? Like, this is...
Well, you guys
They're
said
gonna
that
get crushed.
Wings were the ones who beat this, correct?
Here comes Rubick.
Why Rubick?
Because they want to roam early with the Rubick, okay. And that's what they did in that game. They can also steal Viper Strike. It's a guaranteed spell steal the whole game. It's actually kind of nice against a Drow, for example. It's not an incredible pick. Like, I personally don't think Rubick is the best pick here, but I think they're going to do it. And
what about Clock instead?
They'll try their early roaming.
Clock or SP, maybe?
He could work. Yeah, really? they're both good, yeah. Actually.
I've seen Bristleback do quite well against the Drow Strats as well, just a hero that can run in and not worry too much about being brought
maybe
down
not
too fast.
Against,
is that against Drow and Viper?
Yeah, and...
Yeah, the Viper is actually the problem. Yeah.
If it was just one of them, I think it would be okay.
How important is it for Wings to set up their picks in such they could support a...
There's the Rubick.
Support a Spectre.
Zend, you are on a roll today. I would just like to give you a shout-out. Your predictions have been spot on.
Thanks, Andy. I'm going to kick your ass at pool later. God.
So I like the Darkseer in the sense that obviously Surge is great against both heroes. You can get your whoever you want in and out, like core-wise. But it also has a tendency to be able to punish, I think, a Drow lane in general, where a lot of heroes offlane in the early game might not be able to do. Because Drow, with any support, like you're going to need some method of deep push if you're going to be getting like double shells on these creep waves.
No, you just pick a ranged hero and they just hit.
They just hit the creep.
Yeah, they just
you think
hit
that's
creep.
Enough?
Yeah, and they deny all the creeps either.
Pick support Doom and save Devour.
That is actually legit.
I'm
that's
sure
Lumi legit.
As soon as Lumi sends the Dallas rank, that sounds like the worst thing ever.
Or you could pick Chen to dominate the creep that he, and then you just like jungle with
the creep. You could pick Omni Knight and repel it.
It doesn't debuff the...
It does not get rid of Iron
Chen. It doesn't get rid of Iron Chen.
Oh, okay.
By the way, Energy Pacemaker need to ban Spectre now because they do Darkseer Spectre all the time. XCD love the hero and it wrecks Drow.
Yeah, and I guess you can use Spectre more as like an early mid-game fighter, but I feel like EP will see like a Spectre pick as something almost that they can deal with because they're going to be looking to end the game so fast.
Sure, fair enough.
And it takes Spectre a long time to truly become like late-game scary.
By the way, if you guys hear any like me opening can noises, I'm just opening a can monster, so do excuse me.
He learned from James.
That was impressive, actually. I'm a fan. Well done, Lumi.
How's it taste?
Just like a monster would.
What? Of all the things to say, that's what you say?
I got caught while drinking.
So that means that your brain doesn't work because you're drinking Monster?
His brain doesn't work.
Okay, that's fair. We can just stop.
Yeah. Okay. Not while drinking Monster.
All right, so Energy Pacemaker, they get the Viper. They get the Drow. They take out the Peel. Obviously, very good in the mid late game against both of these heroes for obvious reasons. No way to really get away from the Peel once he's on you. And also, you can doppelganger off or even dodge Viper Strike with the ability. So, I'm thinking Energy Pacemaker still maybe a tiny bit favored.
Just insert random ranged hero as their next three picks, and you're still favored.
Did they still go back for Visage?
Rubick.
If there was like a random ranged hero option, like I feel like they could just click it. Right
you're
going
to be right once, and so here's what you do: you just keep saying Rubick throughout the entire draft. If it doesn't go in this game, no, you know what?
Then he's wrong, right?
I believe in you,
Disruptor. Silence, great, and Glimpse both great against Queen of Pain and Darkseid.
That's
a
good,
really
pick.
Nice pick. Yeah. Unlike Rubick.
Hey, got him.
You didn't guess Rubick.
I said Rubick earlier.
Yeah, but you said Rubick for Energy Pacemaker. You didn't say it for Wings.
I said it for Wings a second pick.
A second pick, but now you got to rehash it every time.
If they would have banned it, I also called Rubick.
Okay.
You just predict that. I think Rubick's like the most picked hero.
Just got to mention some heroes. Like, well, yeah, called
it. Rubick is the most picked hero in the qualifier, probably, or like top two or something.
Yeah.
So chances are you're
okay, I'm going to up my stakes. I'm going to bet all the nothing I just got from that.
Okay.
I'm going to bet it on Lina as their next pick for Wings. Do I get any credit if that's right?
I'll tell you what. If you get the Lina right, all of your nothing is doubled.
Wow, that's great.
I'm thinking Wings will go Shaker into Spectre.
You really think they're going to take Shaker against these heroes?
Well,
how is the Shaker ever going to get farmed on this team?
The Shaker's not getting farmed. He's selling boots and then getting a dagger from a bit.
At 40 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. I still don't think Shaker's going to be picked. Not at least not by Wings.
And like, why isn't... Oh, there you go.
Well, like, I said not by Wings.
I know, that was perfect. Yeah. Like, you timed that not by Wings.
And 1 second off.
Whatever, man. Bullet dodged. Get off me. I got this.
His predictions, if I
this guess, is pure luck.
Better than anyone.
How is it luck? There was no way they were going to take Shaker.
Oh, the nothings are doubled.
What now?
Nothing doubled.
What now?
Well played.
All right, can I triple my nothing if I guess the last one?
All right, I'll tell you what. If you guess the last one, you're back to positive. You no longer have nothing. You now have something.
All right.
That's high stakes, though. You got to guess.
But what do I lose? I lose nothing. So it's like...
Yeah, you lose nothing.
Super value bet.
It's a free guess.
Decent. Okay. Decent odds.
Okay.
He's looking at his phone right now. He's like, all right.
Absolutely. Trying to catch up with the 5-minute delay.
So what core?
I think Spectre is actually still pretty likely for Wings.
Okay.
But it might be the next ban for Energy Pacemaker.
Ooh, Lycan.
Oh, they're going to ban Lycan. I don't think, like, a hero that Wings have played a lot, Morphling, is definitely not the choice. I think even if they really like it on XDD, that is just really awful here.
Disruptor's so good against Morphling.
Yeah, Drow and Viper are also both pretty good. And
what about Gyrocopter? Gyrocopter's still in the pool, by the way.
I don't think Gyro's actually not a good matchup for Gyro. Yeah, Viper and Drow kind of wreck him, I think.
He's good with Vacuum. He's decent with Rubick in lane. So there's definitely some
more
merit.
More to like, stop the push with the big team fight.
Any chance of a Lifestealer? Good old Queen of Pain bombs into the Drow, Disruptor.
It's good against Drow. It's not good against Viper. Wait.
Whoa.
Do they ever play Wisp?
I've seen EP do this a couple, like, not leading up to the qualifiers, they played Wisp once or twice. But
so who's the core?
I mean, Shaker offlane,
Shaker
I think,
offlane,
is...
Yeah.
Okay. Go solo mid Wisp, come on.
That would be fun to see. No lie for a third game.
Well, this is another pocket strat, right, from Energy Pacemaker.
You got, like,
I don't think I've seen them pick Wisp.
You gotta guess, man.
20 seconds.
Spectre.
Okay.
Let's go.
I will say Jug.
Let's go my Wings.
We just...
Oh, okay, we're both wrong. We all lost. Well,
but
that's
this
actually
is a great
a nice
pick.
Pick.
Yeah, this is a great pick.
That's pretty good.
Is it that good against Disruptor, though?
No, it's not good against Disruptor. I think it's good against Drow. I think it does decently against Viper. It's a little bit... It's a special matchup, and
it
owns Wisp.
Yeah, it does well against everything else, pretty much.
Yeah.
Except
for
the Disruptor.
So, I think it's pretty good.
Okay. And...
It's good with Darkseer. We forgot to mention that. Iron Shell on Slark is godlike. So, if they can get a good early game off that... Was that the carry they played when they stomped the Drow strat?
Yes.
Yes, sir. I think they picked Slark in that game, too.
The but game now, ended when he pounced into the Roshan pit with double Iron Shell on, and that was it.
But you have to kind of assume now that maybe EP want to go aggro, right? Because you see Slark picked. And they already have Viper, Drow, and Wisp, so I think there's a really good potential that EP just to completely punish this pick in lane.
They could do that, I guess. I could see that. Safe lane Shaker against...
Shaker's not really... ideal here for I guess you could 1v1 in mid.
No, you don't even have to. You don't have to try lane. You just have to put like maybe just Viper Wisp bottom or something like that, or any like off lane dual lane with range.
I don't think that's enough against Rubick Lina.
Okay.
Because if you catch a telekinesis, it's actually a kill. Telekinesis into pounce into Lina stun. Wisp can't
maybe
deal with that.
Maybe you do need a third hero. Yeah.
So if they put Shaker top, he's 1-on-1 against Darkseer. That's an awful matchup. Mid would be in that case be Quap versus Viper. I guess that's Viper. Or unless, well, if they run the aggressive trial, I guess it's Quap versus Drow.
Yep.
That's okay for Drow, I think. So I mean, they could try it. I think the Shaker will have a hard time, but it might be worth it in the end if they can shut down the Snark.
All right, this is the final game between Wings and EP. I don't think a lot of us expected EP to make it to game three, but hey.
Gods and I actually both said 2-1 wings.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Cinder, how does it?
Cinder and I didn't say it.
How does? Well, Sin's been 100% on with his predictions today.
That is
where
true.
Are you at?
I'm gonna call wings.
Okay.
Yeah, just wings. To keep up my streak.
Wings OP.
Yeah, wings all the way.
We'll have to do one game, I think, at the TI qualifiers where we just do a quad guest. Just YOLO, you know.
No, the whole game is just making predictions and
and laughing and making fun of the people who get their predictions
wrong. What do you
wrong.
Think the next rune will be at bottom, Draskal? Ha, got you. It was a region.
What?
I think this is going to be a bounty.
Maybe.
All right. I got that one right.
No odds. Okay, so we're getting into the game here. Both teams are going to get one bounty rune, respectively. Looking at the lanes, Old Chicken, we already mentioned playing Drow, likely going to end up in that 1v1 scenario. Maybe even has the Wisp come to help him out against the Queen. It looks like he's still in the area. But what do you think, Lumi? What do you think of the lanes?
Seems good.
Seems good.
Yeah.
Thank you for your input.
You're welcome.
Very well said. I guess Super's still kind of here for the time being as well. I mean, they're leaving the Shaker in the off lane versus a Lina and a Sark. It's a lane that can kill him with relative ease, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
He's done the standard, like, block his lane off with a Fissure, try to get it closer to the tower. He'll be able to get a lot here.
I don't think they actually blocked the pull camp, right? So this
you
is
mean,
all.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So this is really all he's gonna get. He's gonna get level 2, maybe check the rune at the 2-minute mark, and maybe gank mid for a bit. But we're gonna see the problem that Cinderin pointed out earlier when we were talking about a Shaker. He's gonna have a hero that really doesn't have a purpose. It feels.
So you don't think that at some point in this game, like if he manages to get up to arcanes, like before like 15 minutes or something like that, you still think it's just gonna be one of those heroes that just kind of sits around and doesn't really do much?
I mean, he could get arcanes and stuff if his team gives him farm priority, which I'm not sure if they will. Nice TP back to the T1. I almost think that Disruptor is just more valuable as a hero with the item than Shaker. And I'm just really sad that teams are... Oh, actually, hold that thought, because that's a perfect block. There's a slow. He's going to toss him back, but Shaker will be able to catch up thanks to the movement
speed. Oh, Roshan Denai. Roshan Denai.
No, he's going to get the punch off. Punch!
No, he doesn't hit him hard enough. He doesn't do enough damage. The Tango healed him up. He wasn't going to get the last hit.
Actually, Rubick had boots, and Shaker does not. So.
Yep.
Well played.
That's super, showing how powerful he can be. Speaking of, Blink taking a very unfortunate trade. Luckily for him, Old Chicken actually missed twice up on the high ground, so he didn't take even more damage off that.
I think I saw a Slippers of Agility purchase on Drow, so I think he's stacking Wraith Bands.
It's pretty common.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's coming up on the courier. There you go. There's another one. Although I think he needs a little bit more regen against the Drow as well. Or never mind. The Wisp is
I was going to say. Yeah. I think he's fine. It's pretty standard to go like Aquila Wraith Band or Aquila double Wraith Band with treads and then just build into like S and Y for the mid game. Just so your team has that ridiculous range damage bonus. Like the Viper in the safe lane is going to get pretty much free farm.
Not that he needs any help.
No, he doesn't. But I mean, just being able to secure the last hit's a little bit easier. You'd be surprised how many people just miss like even like 3 or 4 CS in the first 10 minutes.
Yep. So the last time we were watching this kind of matchup, or hold that thought. I think he's dead now.
Yeah, he's saving Glimpse for a really long time. Has no TP. Could be the first blood. Wants to get into fog. Not going to be able to. Glimpse back. And there is your first blood.
Yep.
It's going to be picked up by LT.
So the last time that when Wings played against a Drow lineup, XCD Slark went for drums first. And then into I think, Shadowblade. And we were kind of questioning, at least Owen and I were saying that maybe the drums was not really necessary. How do you feel about drums first in this case?
For Slark?
Yeah.
I think drums are the item that you buy when the enemy team is pressuring you enough to where you need to react. I think that if you wanted to play a Slark against these types of heroes and they were pressuring you, drums would be a perfectly valid option. I think that Shadowblade is bad against teams that have a tendency to want a 5-man, which I also think the Energy Pacemaker will do at some point, even with a Wisp, just because they have that Drow aura and they have the potential for pushing out really fast. I don't know. I think it has its merits, but most of the time you want to go for like maybe Aquila Treads, just try to farm, max your Dark Pact, then go for either a Shadowblade or like a Blink into Scotty. I think that's pretty much the bread and butter of any Slark.
Yeah, I agree as well. I think drums also could give him a little bit of extra HP, which, I mean, the damage output of EP is going to be very high, in which, you know, the extra 200 health or 100 health will give you the perhaps a pounce away.
Okay, so I have a question for you.
Yep.
How is the Queen 17 and 13 when Drow is Drow and has 8 and 8 CS?
That's a very good question.
Like, how is Blink winning the lane this hard? even when Bold Chicken has a Wisp. I mean, he's not been there 100%
Look
of the
at his damage.
Yeah, he hits for 87. Yeah. The Queen still hits
Is
for like 74.
Is he just missing CS?
He's got to just be getting outlasted really badly and making inefficient trades. That's like the only way I can see you actually winning this, or losing this. And he even has a high ground ward. Like, it's actually insane that he could be losing like this.
I mean, Bold Chicken generally don't lose lanes like this.
Yeah.
So I'm very, very confused as to what happened. Maybe some really advanced micro or aggro tricks from Quap.
He's even skilling, I think, stats, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not the Quap, the Queen, the Drow.
The Drow, of course, yeah. Well, early game here, Slark already picking up his treads. Viper staying pretty consistent CS with a safe laner, so nothing really too surprising there.
Glimpse back.
Yeah, Super kind of caught out here. He's going to lift on the Viper, Fan being thrown back. I think he's still dead, though. He needs, like, maybe one more poison attack. It goes through.
Yep.
That's going to be a kill for Fan. So 3-0 for Energy Pacemaker in this early game.
I mean, they generally always start the game
well.
So
solid rotations, getting a couple of kills, maybe getting like a tier 1 or 2.
Yeah, and they always pick very strong laners for Fan as well as Old Chicken. So it's nothing too surprising, I think. The question is what they're going to do with it. Because this Slark is going to be a big issue eventually. And they don't really have an answer for it apart from just, you know, a good glimpse into a static storm.
My other question would be for him is the Slark timing going to be fast enough to stop Energy Pacemaker from reaching that really scary mid game?
I don't think so if he gets the drums. That's why I think you just need to go for either quick blinks or quick
Shadow Blade.
Yeah. Forgot for a second. Actually, getting Silver Edge and breaking the Nether. That's a free kill. Breaking the Nether Toxin is actually going to be pretty big for the rest of the wings.
If he goes for Silver Edge?
Yeah. Well, if he's going for Shadow Blade, then he's going to definitely go Silver Edge after. A little bit of D War actually on the mid lane. Oh! Surviving 5 HP.
I would actually argue that Silver Edge is better against the Drow than it is the Viper. I mean, sure, removing Corrosive and Nether Toxin is nice, but you take away Marksmanship and Aura? I mean,
imagine if you're going to get close to her, she loses a lot of her...
She dies anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, she loses a lot of the agility bonus, but I still feel like taking it away entirely and the fact that she gets no bonus damage is still maybe a bigger benefit. And plus, you're going on a Viper. I mean...
So what we're saying is Silver Edge is going to be good this game.
It is good, yes. Yeah. It is definitely good.
So we'll see if he's going to go for it.
Now, Super kind of just wandering around.
This is how
for an aggro ward.
That's how he plays Rubick all the time.
Oh,
just
he plays a
heavy
ward,
roam.
Saw it. They're probably going to deward that straight away. That is really unfortunate for Super.
No, they pinged out Ancients. They thought they...
No. He placed a ward before the Rubick was on low ground. And we're going to see a lift here on the Old Chicken.
Oh no!
Okay. That Sonic Wave, the glimpse back onto Blink. He does actually have his Blink off cooldown. Has a regen rune to his name, so he won't have to go back to base. But that timing, that could not have gone any worse. And that would have been a big kill.
Yeah.
The Queen is now starting to fall behind a little bit in last hits. Like, he's still ahead, but compared to what he had before, he wants to go for
this all-in
kill.
He gets a kill anyways?
Oh, there's no bottle charges left on the Drow. How could this happen, Lumi? How could you just stand there and die?
Well, you don't have Gus. That's how. He went all stats in Aura.
I guess that makes it even a more difficult question. If you go all stats in 3 Wraith Bands, how do you actually just die to that? Like... He didn't have...
This game makes no sense.
Okay, I'm like super confused right now. The last two games have been pretty back and forth. You know, even though Wings won game the first game and then EP won the second, they weren't like total stomps either way. Mm-hmm. There was still a lot of conflict in each of them.
These games are getting long. There could be that players are starting to lose a bit of focus.
That's true. I mean,
this is not the time to do it, though.
Everything's on the line here for both of these teams.
Well, you're not eliminated, but... By the way, he's going to try to get that D ward. I think they expected the Ancients to be warded because they pinged the Ancients as soon as they saw the Rubick leaving from that area. But
they could have assumed Ancients instead of the high ground ward. That's true.
So far, nothing was attempted to be D ward.
Well, for now, the early game, it's still pretty quiet. Just a lot of solo kills happening. And top lane, we haven't really checked too much on the Darkseer after the first kill that he had against him, but... Angela is still doing a pretty good job. I mean, he's level 6 right now, almost 7. They're even going to send the Queen of Pain after this lane. The question is, do they actually get... Oh, they're sending a lot more than just the Queen. Okay, here we go.
Hopefully she doesn't miss Sonic Wave this time.
Here comes the bait from Angela. They're going to take it, at least for the start. Blink forward coming in. They're going to be able to take down the Disruptor, no problem.
And I think they should be able to work on this tower for a little bit. Probably can't actually dive that Viper. Yeah, it's, well, actually, I thought he had mech finish. No, he's just got a headdress. XCD is still free farming, by the way.
Well, I mean, it's expected, right?
Yeah. It's like, actually kind of surprising that Viper is leading the CS when you have a free farming Slark on a bottom lane.
Drower, man. Telling you. I actually think that in the top lane, it's much harder for Injilai to lane than it is for the Shaker.
Because he has to dodge around the Iron Shouts and stuff.
Well, Glimpse is ridiculous, right? Oh, so I'm saying that the offlaner is having a harder time from Wings than MG Pacemaker's offlaner.
Yeah. I think EP needs to go for a Roshan sneak. I'd like to see one of support get a medallion, smoke into the Rosh with Drow, and just
who take gets it, though? The Wisp can't really buy it, right?
Maybe the Disruptor? Shaker actually could get it, but obviously he has much more important items to get.
I mean, it would be cool to see, but
yeah,
I kind of doubt that he would be able to put forth that towards or that much gold towards anything that is only for a kind of an all-in maneuver. I don't think they're far behind enough to feel like they need to all-in. Also going to get a glimpse on a JDH here. He's going to go for the immediate teleport out, and will be able to do so.
Smart decision.
One of the downsides of playing a Disruptor when you don't have another support who can stun. Or if you just don't have enough damage. Because I don't think that Fan was in the area. He was kind of walking up the ramp to try to get to him to throw out a Viper Strike, maybe.
I'm personally not a big fan of Bottle on Shaker. Especially when you're not playing a very active roaming style. Because in teamfights, a lot of times you need burst regen to get off another Fissure. And I feel like this is kind of like a waste of 700 gold because you're not fighting much better, you're not ganking much better. Technically, you can be with the bottle, but...
Well, with an Invis and Echo, you can do something, right?
Yes. Let's see if he's going to be actually using it. Well, there's a glimpse back here against Rubick. They will actually get the kill. I mean, this is why I think that Disruptor is such a powerful hero. How many kills have they got just from
Glimpse? Another kill?
That's another kill.
All right, inside the jungle here, we're going to see XD picks out the Wisp.
I think all of the kills they got is from Glimpse.
Yeah,
every single one of them.
That pick for them has done so much work.
Yeah.
Now, how early on did Wings pick Darkseer? Because I think that the Disruptor was a reactionary pick to the hero.
Second
right?
pick?
Yeah, they second picked it. Okay, here comes the Invis. Wait for the Echo. I think he could even solo kill the Queen here.
Well, the creep wave is dying, so a lot of the bounce damage
maybe
is
not. He only has level 1 enchant, but he has level 3 Aftershock. He's going for the Stunlock. Gets the Fissure off. There's the Static
there
Storm to follow it up.
That's it.
But it's not quite enough damage. He's going to blink away. Where's the Glimpse? He's too far.
1600 cast range. Oh my goodness.
Oh, he's so close. Okay, that did not go nearly as well as I thought. I think he didn't have enough mana for enchant. Yeah, he couldn't use the third skill, so instead of being able to stun lock him the entire time, he like needed to echo, bottle charge, fissure, and then enchant to be able to have enough mana.
I mean, that's a perfect example of what I said earlier. You just want burst mana regen.
Yeah, but I mean, he still could have gotten the kills with a bottle is what I'm saying. Like arcanes would have been easier because maybe he thought about it. Like, when he was using his spells, it just hit the arcanes. But being able to just get one bottle charge definitely would have killed both of them.
So I think what happened with the Disruptor is that a lot of Disruptor players are like, okay, I'm going to Thunderstrike for the sight, and then I'm going to Glimpse once they're a little bit out of range. But that Quap just covered so much distance thanks to that Blink buff. This patch, right? She did get a Blink buff.
It was a couple patches ago. Okay. But yeah, she did receive a lot of buffs. 1300 range.
Yeah.
It's very good.
Slark in the enemy jungle, kind of exactly where he wants to be. And this is also really, really good against a team that relies heavy vision to deny these ganks. Slark will scout those wards, and his teammates will deward him.
I think Slark is one of those heroes that is very rare to see against a lineup like Drow Viper in general, just because it's so often seen.
Because of this, right? He can't do anything about this.
Well, yeah, he can't do anything about this, and also in lane, he's extremely weak. Like, there's a reason why we never see him mid.
Yep.
And if he goes to any other lane but safe, it's going to be with supports who are very good during the early game laning phase. It looks like Super maybe going for the Nye. Unfortunately, they hit way too hard. Not going to be able to get it. Power going to be dropping here on the side of EP. Also going to see a Viper Strike onto Injilai. The Glimpse is available. He's got the Thunder Strike vision right now. Tries to vacuum his way out, but not going to be successful here. And Injilai is going to drop. That gives Fan a killing spree.
Yep. Fan is getting really fat. I mean, he got so many kills off Glimpse on the top lane. I also wonder what Disruptor... Is Disruptor getting an item, or is he just getting wards? Please just let him get an item.
I mean, he has arcanes. It's not that bad.
That's not for him. That's for the team.
Yeah, but I mean, still having arcanes isn't bad even for yourself.
I mean, look, if I know I'm getting item for myself, I'm going to straight up get a point booster instead of getting arcane. Or at least a Staff of Wizardry for some utility item. This hero with item just does so much.
Oh, XCD? Going to go for the immediate TP after the Shadow Dance, preventing the glimpse into the Static Storm. Nice play.
Yep. Because you cannot dispel Glimpse. There's nothing that could dispel Glimpse.
Yeah, it pulls you out of Yules, pulls you out of Phase Shift, pretty much just screws you no matter what. Unless you Mantis style it, because then you're actually invulnerable. Same thing with Doppelganger. All right, Old Chicken getting dove behind the tower here. Laguna to follow up the mist on Dragon Slave to be there as well, along with a Fade Bolt. Blink gets that kill. Teleport reaction coming in. It's going to be Fan. JDH going for the immediate TP. It seems really the weakness of their draft is just Teleport Scrolls at this point. Queen going up to the high ground here. Going to throw out a Shadow Strike and a Scream. He gets Viper Struck. I think he's going to die to the damage before the TP actually goes off. Oh, he
Slark,
barely
though.
Lives. Slark coming in. He actually gets caught out by an Echo Slam into an Enchant and a Fissure. Looks like he didn't have his Dark packed up or his Shadow Dance that time. Angel Eye making his way out of the team fight. Glimpse was up, but I do not believe they had Vision.
I think killing the Slark was huge, but like you said, EP just can't get kills because Wings just straight up TP out. They have, what, two ways to cancel it? Three if you count Enchant Totem or Echo Slam.
I mean, the Shaker has three ways. The Disruptor has one.
Yeah, pretty much it.
But still, that
if he has an Aghanims.
Okay, true. That's true. I think he probably would go Aghanims eventually in this game as well.
I sure hope so. It's so good against Queen of Pain.
And Slark, too.
Yeah.
Because if you get caught out by the storm right away, and like say you get fissured, it gets time for the field to go up, and then you just can't pop BKB and you just die.
Yep.
It's very, very strong.
So I believe Roshan is being started here by EP, and they definitely have the damage to do it. Yeah, Fan should just tank it for the draw.
Yeah, Mask of Madness. Something that we don't see super often anymore. Not like last patch, where it was almost every single game.
I feel it's very dangerous to get Mask of Madness against this Wings lineup, though.
I think it is dangerous in the sense that the Slark and the Queen, maybe even the Lina, have the opportunity to blow you up. But I also think maybe they could have gotten Roshan without the Mask of Madness, but it does help. Like, just having that item that allows you to get that pushing speed just a little bit faster. Shaker also, now with the Blink Dagger, at just 16 minutes as an offlane.
Yeah. EP is overall playing really well in this first about 15, 16 minutes. They're getting the key items they need. Shaker done with Blink. They have a... Quabba's also doing well, though, with the Aghanims almost being finished. How do you feel this game is going to shape in the next 5 to 10 minutes?
I think if Wings manage to delay it to ultra late game, the Slark will just carry,
yeah,
and the Queen as well.
I don't think he'll get there.
But I think Energy Pacemaker have the opportunity to just straight up end the game.
Yeah.
Like, I think their lineup actually has that much fighting potential, especially with a Shaker having the Blink. Like, if they get one or two good engagements into tier 2 pushes with the help of their Aegis,
this could
think
be
they
it,
can just...
Like, if you Echo both the supports, here comes right, a Blink, Enchant, Fissure, trying to block a little bit of... Echo could just get the kill, but looks like they won't want to use it. Right now, the Lina kind of stuck there in the middle. Meanwhile, Slark coming, trying to do a little bit of Static Storm, not hitting anybody, but the Glimpse back. It's going to be the kill, I believe. No, there's a little bit of magic wand up. I will say we'll hit on Fan, though. Fan does have the mech. He should be absolutely fine. There you go. Getting a whole bunch of HP back. Slark pouncing back in, not connecting there. Echo is going to get used on two heroes. My goodness. That's two more kills. Can they get at the high ground? Glimpse? He's trying to Dark Pact. They have Vision. Oh, Glimpse is going to come back in. He's going to have to Shadow Dance, protect himself a little bit. But this Shaker doing a lot of work. No Enchant there. And he's out, but four heroes dead. EP looking for high ground.
Okay, so that actually went way worse for Wings than I thought it would. The Echo coming in from the Shaker was absolutely massive to stop two heroes from being able to act at all.
Yeah.
And they even lost, I think it was Super at the start of the fight. I mean, even the Queen didn't get to do anything, so Blink pretty much not able to add anything in terms of contribution. And not having buybacks this early is pretty common, so 18 minutes. Energy Pacemaker looking to go high ground. Teleport coming in from JD.
Al Glimpse
back!
Oh my
XDD
goodness.
Still waiting for his ultimate to come off cooldown. There is going to be a lift, but with the Mask of Madness, it doesn't do a whole heck of a lot. XCD trying to force Energy Pacemaker back, but they just don't care.
18
they get the melee
racks. Well, they're going to probably get a kill. Drow Ranger now just running out there. She still has Aegis.
That's, the mech timing. Alright, I think they need to chase this.
By the way, I just have to credit the fact that Shaker has not given away Fissure once to Rubick. And obviously, you could easily Enchant Totem after every Fissure, but just good heads up.
You know what I love about this game?
Yeah.
The fact that Cinderin was hating so hard on Shaker and he's actually winning the game for his team. Well, maybe not winning it for his team, but he's done very well.
He did really well in that fight. Yeah. To me, the MVP right now is Disruptor.
I have to rip on Cinderin because I love him. You know, it's an affection thing.
Well, Enchant Totem, Fissure, but he blinks away and chase. This is like...
This is low speed chasing right now.
Yeah. I mean, it could be high speed if we watch all the frames.
all the frames are for noobs, Lumi. We only need like a fifth of the frames a fifth of the time. So I guess that's 1 in 25, right? Something like that.
Yeah, good.
Fractions are hard. So Slark, maybe he's going for the BKB rush. Maybe he just feels super unsafe and trying to go into the team fight against the Shaker, against a Disruptor so early. Even just having a Shadow Blade, he could very easily just get caught out and die.
Yeah, it seems like, especially against the Static Storm, the BKB first is very valid. It also allows you to kind of spread the Darkseer damage through the Iron Shell. I don't think that EP is going to be focusing on kind of right-clicking the Slark. So the BKB is actually going to protect him for quite a bit.
We'll see if he's able to make anything happen with it, as right now, it's 20 minutes in and Wings are down a Rax, a team that I even personally thought were going to take the series 2-1. So if it goes the way of Energy Pacemaker, a lot of people were talking about how this team was somebody, or a group of five, who overperformed, maybe. Like, got to a point in the TI qualifiers that not a lot of people were expecting them to get to. And now they're looking to take down one of the other favorites in Wings.
Still overperforming, perhaps?
Maybe not overperforming anymore. After a while, it becomes an expected level, right?
I guess so. And they're going to look to Siege Tier 2, Shaker all his stuff up. I believe...
God, he is so farmed, actually.
Yeah, he is.
Like, Blink Force at 20 minutes? I mean, yeah, killing the Rax gives you a pretty good influx of gold, but... I mean, he's higher net worth than the... Well, than most everyone that's not a core.
He's definitely higher net worth than the Darkseer, which is impressive, considering that Darkseer farms much faster.
Yeah.
Here we go, T2. Not going to get defended at all.
I think it's the right call, though. I don't think Wings can fight an open field. This Slark needs BKB before Energy Pacemaker goes high ground.
There's
that
Aghanim.
Blink just finishes up his Aghanim, so that's really good. But he's still quite a ways away from that BKB. Still needs around 800 more.
Right. Wings is calling for a flank from the north side.
Aegis faded. That's actually good for Wings.
Good war being dropped.
Okay. Which one went down first?
They all went down first. Drop's going to get used.
Okay.
They're going to jump in now. Surge. They're looking for a vacuum. Vacuum LSA. Can we get a Static Storm on top? BKB has to be used by Fan. In fact, they're actually glimpsed back into the where they came from. On the back line here, Slark being forced to jump away. Nobody dies, but...
Well, we're missing a glimpse again. Did the Static Storm actually not hit anything, or was that just
no,
Perfect World?
No, Perfect World. It hit the Lina as well as the Darkseer as they were coming in.
All right, well.
Glimpse?
See, one glimpse onto Fan. Doesn't look like the Pounce made contact there.
The only
walk away.
The only downside for EP is that they actually used their BKB on Viper and Echo Slam. And they're deciding to still keep on pushing with it.
I think they're just a lot stronger. Like, seeing the Stark not having a BKB. I mean, look at this tower. It's almost dead already.
Yeah.
It's at, like, 10% health. Might get denied. See if Wings are able to do so. Actually have no idea who got it. I'm expecting Fan. Yep, there we go.
Wings is like, why are we dealing with this again? I thought this ain't happening on game 3.
It's happening even faster than it did in the second game.
Yeah.
It took 37 minutes for Energy Pacemaker to win the second game.
SMY Drow. Main and Frost.
Oh, it's on level 2 Frost arrows.
Yeah.
Did they change? I think they changed the scaling, right? Yeah, okay. It's 15% difference at every level. It used to be where like the fourth point was so much better than every other point that most every drow had to max it. But nowadays, you can actually split your points a little bit better because each level of Frost Arrows has the equal level effectiveness. The more you know.
Them actually backing up surprises me a bit because, like you said, there's no BKB on Slark. So they could have actually forced the issue quite a bit. But now...
He bought Blink twice and sold it. Sorry, I was confused.
Yeah, buy, sell, buy. Does he really need the blink, though?
No. He sold it again, I think. Oh, no, he does have it.
Yeah, it's coming. I guess you just, like, blink in and force the fight to happen, but...
I think when you're in such a strong position, having a blink dagger means that any time, like, the Lina or the Rubick are caught outside of the base, or maybe even the Queen, if he doesn't throw a dagger on you before he blinks away, you can just follow him. Like, you can just get a Viper Strike, blink forward, just keep... giving him the glorp, and then he just dies.
Great ward by Wings on the low ground. Not going to get scouted. Perfect vision. Exactly what they need. But let's see if vision is enough to actually stop this. Glimpse back here. Going to go on Fan. Fan still has a BKB.
It's a very risky situation. They do manage to steal the Viper Strike, though. I want to say that's one of the first times this game Super has gotten it. I know he's stolen Glimpse a handful of times, and he might have gotten Fissure, but Viper Strike is so good to steal.
And... so easy to steal. Surprised that he hasn't actually gone for it. DD or XDD on the high, on the front lines. Very, very slow push from EP. Patience, well,
The thing is, if anybody ever gets out of position even once, then the Disruptor can just glimpse them back into a guaranteed kill, or the Shaker can go in for a Blink Echo. And then it's just, you either have to buy back if your wings, or you potentially lose another set of racks. And at 25 minutes, they don't have the heroes to deep push it.
This could be big. They're looking to fight right now. Darkseer has the Blink. If they could get Vacuum and LSA, here comes the wall. It hits on everybody. They just blow up the Wisp immediately. BKB gets used. The mech came out late. Static Storm looks like really got nobody except the Darkseer, but Darkseer has really done his job. And they're chasing. Slark going to work, actually misses the pounds. Not sure if they want to focus on Fan. It's time to back up here. LSA Echo hits on three. Oh my goodness. And the push goes the other way. Queen of Pain dies. And Slark is the only one alive. Well, Darkseer is healing as well. I think that's going to be another lane of racks.
That Echo, though. Honestly, like, what more could you have asked for him in that situation? Looks like they were tunnel visioning a bit too hard, trying to get more value out of chasing them out of the base. Are they really going to try to go all in here? A couple of auto attacks landing on XCD, blink forward, vacuum onto one. Old Chicken going to pop that Mask of Madness and run away. Here comes the silence. I think that was one auto attack missed up high ground by the Drow. They're going to go in for the melee racks. And July wants to go back in. He does have that Blink Dagger. Kinetic Field trying to zone out the side of Wings so they can get more damage on the racks. They might lose a Disruptor. Glimmer Cape is popped. Still very tense situation. Can they keep the melee racks alive? Everyone's kind of getting low here, just sitting in the front line. Viper Strike stolen once again by this Rubick. Cast on Old Chicken inside of the base. Fissure comes out to try to help him. Injuli going to be the first one to drop. And it looks like Slark is going to quickly be following suit. Teleport in, coming in from the Queen. Has ulti available, throws it out. Only hits on the Wisp.
Oh, no.
It's not enough damage. He gets silenced up. Blink forward and a chant from the Shaker. Doesn't even need it.
That's
gets
it.
The kill.
GG.
Good game. Well played. Energy Pacemaker. Take the series 2-0.
Those Echo Slams. Those Echo Slams from Shaker. Holy.
Okay, so I gotta be totally honest. I actually thought that Wings would be able to defend and just win the game because they had Slark late game.
Yep.
Like, that's what I actually thought was gonna happen. But in the end, it seems like the rare form of the Shaker in the offlane ended up getting a lot out of his offlane. And then he had that Blink Dagger before 20 minutes. He got a 4 staff around the 20-minute mark. And then it was just his plays, I feel, solidified the win for the team.
Yeah, I felt that if Radiant had a bit more time, like the Blink Darkseer, we saw how much impact they had. If they had played it a little bit tighter, maybe they could be living on borrowed time for maybe 5-10 more minutes, and then who knew what would happen. But well play epic energy pacemaker,
epic, right?
Well play epic energy pacemaker.
Amazing what an Earthshaker can do when he's not getting a 38 minute Blink Dagger by selling his boots.
Yeah, it was really impressive. Yeah. I think for this game, he's definitely my MVP. Like, Jatulay played a great game.
Yeah, and I think draft-wise, something a bit different from NG Pacemaker. Like, they used the Wisp pretty well, but all in all, this was, just a really good showing. I think the Drow Viper slipping through was a bit of a mistake to give that up, but by Wings.
I don't know if the Slark timing...
I'm not sure it was the Drow Viper, though.
I think it was the combination of the Drow Viper and then last picking the Slark. I think that hero... Okay, so it's very volatile. It either loses the game in the first 30 minutes... which we just saw.
Or win the
game.
Or
if you manage to turtle it out and don't lose a set of racks, then you just auto-win because it's almost impossible for that lineup to deal with a late-game Slark. So I just felt like they didn't quite have the time necessary to make sure that XDD could really get the farm.
Yeah.
Even though he didn't farm slow, it was just they were under constant pressure, so it just couldn't get enough.
And they had Disruptor and Earthshaker, both great heroes, often against Slack, but if they run them both as supports, we've seen the Earthshaker never getting any farm. But the fact they had one of them as a core, the Disruptor doesn't really need the farm as much as an Earthshaker did, just meant they had actual answers for the Slark in the mid game, and he could never get to those late game items that he needed.
Yeah, I really like the Disruptor pick too. I feel just having a one hero that can just totally screw over Darkseer in the offlane, like Jatulay had a much easier time than Injuli did. Injuli was like, okay, well, if I ever show myself in lane, if I don't have vision, I have a potential of just immediately dying, and there's almost no way I can get out.
He said to like TP out a couple times. And
I think he TP'd out once or twice in the early game. But other than that, like he had to go back to jungle farming and like kind of push out lanes and such. But in the end, it just didn't matter.
Yeah. As I said, Wings were going to win. We got it right.
Yeah.
Just like Caster's Curse. Wings are going to win. Shaker is not a good pick. Yeah.
I had to shout you out during that game. It's so ironic that we talk about it. And then literally the game after is just...
Yeah. Yeah. But it's good to see that they made it work. I was a little bit skeptical for EP with the Wisp last pick, but it seemed like they really found a way of making it work. The Drow and Viper got... It's not really that good of a matchup for Slark, I think. I don't know if it was like a fluke last time that Wings just absolutely ran over their opponent or if they didn't play the strat that well, but I guess they were... I mean, you can't blame them for feeling confident going into this game. They've beaten a Drow strat before with Slark, with... what was it? It was Slark, Rubick, and Lina, actually. Those three heroes were quintessential to that win, so I can understand why they tried it again, but I guess this time they were just up against a better opponent, and yeah, they go home.
All right, well... What else do we say? I mean, I guess there's one more thing to talk about during that game is the middle lane. It seemed like Blink was doing very well in his matchup. Like, he was playing Queen of Pain up against the Drow and the Wisp, and I felt like he got a ton out of that lane. And when I saw that, my first thought was, okay, well, the early laning phase is something that Drow compositions are supposed to win, like on paper. But I guess their mid-game timing was a little bit too strong. Like, they didn't have enough core items up on their heroes to be able to stop the push ever. So I don't know if it was the fact that their lineup was never meant to be able to win at that point in the game, or maybe if they played it just a tiny bit better, they could have just snowballed and won. Yeah.
Drow strats is so weird. So many times I watch a game like, oh, they've dealt with the Drow strat, the early game didn't go well, and then suddenly all it takes is one team fight, you've taken Roche, and three towers are gone, and suddenly, oh, okay, the Drow strat's back online. There's never a point where it feels like you've well and truly shut down the Drow strat, unless it's like 30-plus minutes in and the Drow team is behind. But yeah. You really have to not make a single mistake. It's such an unforgiving kind of combination. I mean, be it with a Drow Viper, a Drow Visage, whatever kind of draft you concoct around it.
Yeah, that's actually a crazy thing. In this game, the first two kills go to EP, and already then, they're actually pretty far ahead. The Rubick Lina are under pressure to make stuff happen. I think they tie up at one point at 5-5, and that's actually not good enough. I think the whole problem of their draft and the entire game goes back to like minute zero. They need to get stuff done. We've talked about it quite a bit on previous games, that when you run Rubick Lina, maybe you want to smoke before the creep waves even clash mid and just instantly go for first blood, for example. But if those few moves in the beginning don't work, and let's say, for example, there's a core shaker on the enemy team, you've got a Rubick and a Lina minute 15 to 20, if they don't get any momentum going in the early game, they're actually pretty weak at that point. You're playing into a lineup that has two heroes that can like four-shot you, and all of your potential just goes down the drain. So I think Wings needed to snowball. They didn't. And then they actually are expected to lose that game from that alone.
Yeah, I would say that's fair. Yeah. You know, like any mid-game push lineup against Slark usually does well.
Yeah.
It's just very uncommon to see somebody actually lose the game when... I mean, even for example, Xiao Tule bottom, he had the Invis rune, right? He gets a double echo, doesn't bottle to be able to enchant totem, and then two heroes get away. I'd say a lot of stuff happened that game that actually gave an opportunity for Wings to get themselves back into the game. It just never really felt like they were able to take that one decisive fight that just says, ah, now we're back in it.
It's definitely a very different Wing than we saw versus C-Deck yesterday. The one that yesterday, they made all the right decisions towards the late game. Today, they kind of fell flat. It felt like they never got to execute a game plan, which goes back to, I guess, Rubick Lina didn't get enough things done. And going back to what you said, if you actually moved past that 30 minutes, if you survived the early onslaught, I think Wings was going to take it. So,
I think one of the things there is that Wings were very comfortable against Seek, even though, okay, they lost 2-0 against Seek, but they had close games. They look really solid, but Seek play very standard. Look at the heroes and strats energy Pacemaker are doing.
True.
And you're like, what the hell is this? They did that 5-man push strat, even this last game. Yeah, they Drow Viper, we've seen quite a bit of that, but they threw in the Wisp as a last pick. They had the Urshaker and the offline as a core. EP have been picking all kinds of bizarre things that put Wings really just out of their comfort zone.
This makes me wonder if Wings did well yesterday, were they worse today? Or like, were they worse today or CDIC just not that good is the question.
I think
CDIC going
not...
up against EP, I think EP have a shot. Honestly,
yeah,
at that.
I actually would agree. I think that... Okay.
Well, how many of these strats are pocket strats that they cannot pull out again?
They're not like pocket strats.
The Abaddon, I think, was...
The second game was kind of pocket strat.
You think
but
that?
Not
but did the Wisp last pick really do anything?
I mean,
not
the third
this
game.
One.
You mean second game. Yeah, second game was a pocket strat.
Kind of. But I would agree, the Wisp could have been other heroes, and I think they would have been fine, too.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I don't know. It's more the fact... I don't know if these are pocket strats or not, but they seem to have like a little flavor they can add to every game. Like, they put out something unusual, and we haven't really seen that from C-Deck. They're fairly predictable in like their progression through the draft. I also think that was one of their weaknesses today against Ehome, where Ehome had them figured out. They actually gave them what they wanted, and then they just beat them pretty handily, and especially in game one. So I don't know, really. I think before today, I would expect C-Deck or Ehome, whoever lost, to be clear favorites against the winner of this series, and now I'm not so sure anymore.
Yeah, they played a very solid series overall.
Do you guys think either of the two teams left have a chance against Ehome in the finals, though? Or is that...
They may be on another level. But it's hard to say, right? Like, maybe C-Deck just didn't bring their A-game to that series against Ehome earlier. Maybe we're going to see Energy Pacemaker go up against C-Deck, and then C-Deck show that they can be, like, just as steamrolly as Ehome are, and then we see then back against C home again.
Okay.
Yeah. If anyone has a chance at C deck.
Yeah, I agree. All right. With that, we are done with the Chinese qualifier for today. I think coming up next is America. In a couple of hours, right?
Yeah. I believe we have a schedule for that. Yeah, I'm not sure if that was moved or not. Okay. We're being told it's 23 CEST.
So about 9 hours from now.
That's in quite a while.
Yep. So quite a while. Meanwhile, we're going to be doing some activities on the Mango stream. I believe there's going to be Mafia.
Yeah.
Plus other games.
I think Hotbit had another game planned as well.
Yeah.
One of his creations.
And then China will continue again tomorrow. Might be the same time, might be earlier. Who knows?
Yeah. Supposedly today
we're supposed to know, but.
Nobody's told us.
Today was supposedly going to start earlier than it did. And then they switched it around.
Poor Sindarin woke up at 4 in the morning. And
I got here early, guys.
I lucked out.
I was alone.
Because I actually overslept by like 30 minutes. And then I show up. I'm like, nothing's going on. All right.
Yep. Professional. Mm. Yep. Really good.
Okay, with that, we are going to go take a long break. Tune into the Mango stream if you'd like to see some of us playing. But we'll see you later.